Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to First Congregational Church of Elgin. I'm Reverend Dr. Jesse Tanner. I'm the pastor here at FCC. Thank you for coming to the second of three of our concert series this year, where we're continuing a long and rich tradition of cultivating the musical arts here in Elgin, the communities that we serve. Every concert is free admission, but of course, we would ask you to consider giving a donation. There is a table with an offering plate on it in the back. You can certainly contribute that way, or you could send a check in to our church office putting spring concert series in the memo. Also, I want you to take a look at the back of your program and see upcoming dates. There's another spring concert coming up in 2 weeks from now, the Chicago Harp Quartet, and Holy Week services and Easter services here at FCC. A couple of housekeeping items. There are restrooms located out in the sitting area near our church offices out here, as well as down the hall and by the nursery to the right. And so look for signs. We have signs pointing you in the right direction. Also, we ask that you, if you haven't done it yet, to please silence your cell phones. Thank you for that. There are CDs for purchase in the back. There's a back table back there. I think the CDs are $20. $20 a piece, so please consider checking out the table before you leave today. That being said, this afternoon's concert will be performed by Kathleen Monson, soprano, with Marianne Kim on piano. Please join me now in welcoming Classically Celtic.
Thank you all so much. Like Reverend Jesse said, my name is Kathleen. Kathleen Monson, and we have Marianne Kim here on the piano today. And we're just delighted to be here this afternoon. If you can't tell from my appearance, I come from a very rich heritage of Irish and Scottish descent. So I absolutely love some of these great Irish tunes. However, I studied classical music, so I kind of took some of my favorite songs and try to kind of make them with a bit of a classical twist. So that first one I'm sure many of you are very familiar with. But this next set of music, some of you might not know, Beethoven actually composed quite a few folk songs. In fact, it was one of the largest things he composed, 179 folk song arrangements that he actually did. The problem is most of them actually are quite terrible. They're not very good. So these are some, after listening to many, many of them, these are some of the most popular ones that are performed, these next four pieces. So please enjoy his take on some of these great Irish and Scottish folk tunes.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. So if you notice, the English in those were kind of a little strange. And that's because that's the original text that Beethoven actually set that to. So this next piece on the program is one of my personal favorites. This is a great, you can say Scottish or Irish melody, called the Skyboat Song. But I'm sure many of you might recognize it. There was a show that came out after a great book series called Outlander. And there's this wonderful melody at the beginning of it. So this is a wonderful arrangement that we found.
Thank you.
Thank you all. So the last piece was, I'm sure, one that many of you recognize, Down by the Sally Gardens, but that arrangement was actually by the wonderful composer Benjamin Britten. This next piece, I thought I'd take a stab at arranging another piece for our trio. And in case you haven't noticed, it's a solo up here today. So it's just me today, but it's a great little piece that many of you, I am sure, will recognize. It's a tune from Scotland and Ireland called Red is the Rose. So please enjoy this arrangement. So Marianne and I met a while ago, I'll just say that. One of the things that Marianne is multi-talented in, I just sing, but she plays organ, piano, and also has a double master's with piano performance as well as jazz. So I love performing with her because I like to moonlight as a jazz singer. However, we're not gonna do a bunch of jazz on our Celtic concert today, but this next piece, I love it because she's able to improvise a little bit and show some of her amazing talent with that. This next piece is one some of you might be familiar with. It's called How Are Things in Glockamora. It's from the wonderful musical Finnegan's Rainbow.
Here.
you all so much. This next piece is one of my favorite pieces. I don't know if any of you remember like the great 90s VHS that came out from Dublin called Riverdance. My mom got that, and I remember, I was telling Marianne, I remember dancing around my living room, pretending that I could Irish step dance. Turns out I can't. But this piece, I was like, I have to put this somehow on my program. I don't know how. So I found this wonderful arrangement of it. And one of the other gals that I work with, I was like, play this, and she just was hum-drum-drum. She's just like, what is this? I don't know what this is. And I was explaining to Marianne, too, I was like, have you never heard of Riverdance? So anyways, I forced my friend to watch the full video, and I sent the link to Marianne, too, and I was like, you must watch this, your life will be changed. So please enjoy this wonderful piano arrangement from Riverdance.
Thank you.
feel that one doesn't need much of an introduction. This next piece, though, is a great little ditty I found. I was actually trying to find some Mother's Day songs during the pandemic. We were selling singing Mother's Day cards, and I came upon this great little piece. So if you can imagine just sitting back in a pub and hearing somebody sing this, I don't know if this really qualifies as my mother, though my mother is very Irish, and so is both my grandmothers. So they're a bit of spitfires, but this is a great little ode to those of you who have an Irish mother.
Oh, Many of you recognize some of the tune called The Last Rose of Summer. That was actually a wonderful arrangement by Mendelssohn. So this next piece on the program, you might be thinking, why is there an Italian piece on the program? I thought we were celebrating Ireland. Well, it comes from my classical background. So this is an aria from the opera Lucia di Lammermoor, which is takes place in Scotland. And since it's my concert, that's Irish enough for me. So we're going to sing an aria. So please enjoy Regnava nel Silenzio.
Mm-hmm.
We have just one more piece for you this afternoon. A big thank you to Jeff and Reverend Jesse for having us this afternoon. Thank you all for choosing to spend your afternoon with us. I know there's a lot going on in town today and kind of throughout Chicago, so thank you so much for spending it with me and Marianne. I hope this kind of put you in the St. Patrick's Day Celtic spirit. This last piece is one of my very favorites. It's called 10,000 Miles Away. It actually originated in the United Kingdom and was a sea shanty. And the 10,000 miles is supposed to represent the distance between the United Kingdom and Australia, which is where they used to send prisoners. But then it was, of course, taken up by, of course, Ireland and Scotland, and then moved to America. So this is a great arrangement by the wonderful composer Stephen Marcone.